Thank you and welcome to the show this morning. The topic this morning is Sudan, and we're fortunate to have with us a student from Tennessee State University, Mr. SAminimos1, to talk about Sudan and some of his experiences in that country, as well as some of the things that other students as well as non-students from this East African nation are doing. And of course, Mr. SAminimos1, let me welcome you to the show this morning and to tell you how delighted we are to have you, primarily because we hear so much about what is going on in Sudan and et cetera, but we rarely have an opportunity to have somebody from Sudan to come and to talk about some of the challenges that's facing this country, this great country in a real sense. Let's do that by having you to start off by giving us some information about your background, your education, and some of those experiences that eventually led you to Tennessee State University, and then we'll have an opportunity to talk about Sudan and some of the challenges that are facing this great country today.
Okay. Thank you very much, Dr. James Hain. It is a pleasure being here. And it was a pleasure being in your history class. Actually, I was born in one of the small cities in Sudan. It's called Torit, in eastern Equatorial States, southern Sudan. I was born there to the family, my father and a parent. My father married two women. The other wife has five kids. Mm-hmm. Then we also five. Altogether we're 10. Mm-hmm. And I was the last born from my mother. Mm-hmm. And my mother was the first wife to my father. Mm-hmm. They passed away. My mother passed away in the 90s. My father passed away in 2005. And my stepmother is still alive. And this has been my part of my life. And I have 9 brothers, mm-hmm. 1 sister, which is the youngest in our family. And part of my education background, I was a Sudanese refugee in Uganda, which is East Africa. Mm-hmm. I was there for about 9 years, and I went to my primary school in Uganda. Because I didn't have a chance to go to school in Sudan due to the conflict in the region. And I started my primary school in Uganda, and in 2001, I started the process for resettlement, mm-hmm. To come to the United States. Mm-hmm. I was delayed for another 2 years. But I first finished my primary school in 2000, mm-hmm. in Uganda. So 2001, I started the process to come for resettlement to the United mm-hmm. States. And in 2003, I came to the United States. And when I came to the United States, I was already over 18 years old. So I was not able to go to high school. And the fact that I was still a primary complete graduate in Uganda. So when I came here, there was no way I can go to high school. And I decided and stayed for 3 months. The Catholic charities, they helped me to find me a job in 3 months. So I was working. And I was not even thought of going to school again, because since I was old already, I did not know that I was be able to go to high school to get a high school diploma that can take me to the college. Mm-hmm. So I stayed for almost 5 years. 5 years actually, I stayed for 5 years. I was not, I was not in the school. Mm-hmm. I was just working, mm-hmm. so I was making the money. I never thought of going to school. Mm-hmm. So after that 5 years, I decided that I have to go to school and. Somebody told me about the GED, good. General Education Equivalent Diploma of a high school. So I decided I went to Job Corp. Job Corp is the one in Memphis. Mm-hmm. It was called Memphis Job Corp. Mm-hmm. Memphis Job Corp Center. Mm-hmm. But recently was changed to be the name Dr. Benjamin L. Hooks, mm-hmm. Job Corp Center. It's located in Memphis. So I went there and I did my training, mm-hmm. in accounting. Vocational training in accounting, mm-hmm. and I came there with a GED, which was less than 8 months, mm-hmm. so I get both a GED and vocational training, mm-hmm. in accounting. Again, that was 2006, so I stayed again, and from there that was like so I have to get another a job that can take me to make me prepare for the college, so I prepared to go for the college, my advisor from Benjamin L. Hooks, mm-hmm. advised me to go to Northwest community mm-hmm. college in Memphis. But my brothers were staying in Nashville. Mm-hmm. And so I had to come back to Nashville and apply to TSU. Mm-hmm. So I was accepted to be admitted to TSU, Tennessee State University.
Very good. And of course, mm-hmm. Simon, let's stop it right there in terms of this part of it, because we're going to have a first commercial break. But so far, you've given us some excellent information in terms of your whole transition from Sudan to United States and involved in education. And of course, we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.